Good morning, everyone. I am Dr. Harika, third year postgraduate in the Department of Radio Diagnosis in NRI Institute of Medical Sciences, Visakhapatnam. Today, I am going to present a comparative study between conventional MR sequences, including time of flight MR venography and contrast enhanced MR venography, in diagnosing cerebral venous sinus thrombosis. CVT is not an uncommon condition and is potentially treatable cause with low mortality. Its clinical presentation is varied and often dramatic, and it often affects young to middle-aged patients and more commonly women. The aim of this study is to compare the accuracy between conventional MR sequences and contrast-enhanced MR venography in diagnosing CVT, thereby trying to avoid exposure of the patient to contrast and also save time in diagnosing CVT. This is to start early treatment as soon as possible at an appropriate time. This study was done in the Department of Radio Diagnosis, NRIMS, Visakhapatnam, over a duration of 18 months between December 2019 and June 2021. The source of the data included all the patients with signs and symptoms of headache, convulsions, altered sensorium, focal neurological deficit, and cranial nerve palsy referred to our department for MRI scan of the head. It included approximately 60 cases sent for MRI scan of the brain with signs and symptoms. The inclusion criteria were all the patients suspected to have CVT. The exclusion criteria were the patients who are not willing for the study and all the patients with absolute contraindications for MRI. The pre-contrast images were taken followed by post-contrast images after administration of 0.1 millimoles per kg body weight of gadolinium intravenously. The standard imaging protocol was followed. CVT is an important cause of stroke in young. More than 100 causes of CVT have been recorded, but even in 20 to 25 cases after extensive investigation, still no cause can be identified. 50% of the strokes in Indian women are related to pregnancy and puerperium. Neuroimaging is the cornerstone in the diagnosis of CVT. The imaging modality of choice is MRI with MR venogram, but MRI with MR contrast venography is almost 100% diagnostic. Coming to the anatomy of the venous system, the three groups of veins that draw the blood supply from the brain are superficial cerebral, deep cerebral, and the veins of posterior fossa. The superficial cerebral veins, depending on the venous sinuses into which they empty, are divided into dorsomedial system that drains into the superior sagittal sinus, posteroinferior system that drains into the lateral sinus, and anterior system that drains into the cavernous at the pterygoid venous plexuses via the sylvian vein. The deep cerebral vein, there are three pairs of veins, that is choroid vein, septal and thalamocerebellar vein, that unite behind the interventricular foramen of Monroe to form the internal cerebral veins. The point of the union is called as the venous angle. The etiology of CVT can be varied. It can be due to antithrombin deficiency, protein C, proteinase, pregnancy, puerperium, etc. Pathogenesis can be infective, embolism, local endothelial damage or hypercoagulability. The unenhanced MR imaging is usually more sensitive than unenhanced CT for detection of venous thrombi. The primary finding of sinus thrombosis on MR images is the absence of phloroid and the presence of altered signal intensity in the sinus on routine T1 T2 sequences. GRE imaging may be an important diagnostic aid in acute stage thrombosis, especially when the signal intensities on T1 T2 images are more subtle. The stage of formation of the thrombus is the easiest stage to detect a thrombus, and the finding of increased signal intensity on both T1 and T2 images is consistent with subacute stage of thrombosis. Chronic thrombosis with incomplete recanalization of the sinus may pose a diagnostic challenge at MR imaging. As many as 15% of patients in whom sinus thrombosis is diagnosed at MR imaging may have a chronic 15-day-old thrombus. Compared with the MR signal in the normal brain parenchyma, the signal in a chronic thrombus is typically iso to hyperintense on T2 weighted images and iso intense on T1 weighted images. So these are some images showing partially recanalized thrombosis in the left transverse and sigmoid sinuses compared to the right transverse and sigmoid sinuses. The enhancement is also less compared to the right side. These are the axial flare images showing bilateral thalamic hyperintensities, and the corresponding MR venogram image shows non-visualization of the deep venous system that is consistent with thrombosis. This is the image of a female patient, 57-year-old, presenting with headache. The sagittal and coronal MRV MIP images shows no flow in the anterior one-third of the superior sagittal sinus and also the distal portion of the right transverse sinus. In our study, majority of the patients were in the age group of 20 to 30 years, almost 60%, followed by more than 30 years, that is 27%. majority were females, constituting approximately 58%. The most common symptom of presentation was headache, constituting approximately 83%, that is followed by vomiting, convulsions, and hemiparesis. In our study group of 60 patients, 50 cases were in the acute subacute stage, accounting for 83%, followed by 10 cases which were in the chronic stage, accounting to 17% of the cases. In the acute or subacute cases, most of them were hyper intense on sagittal T1 weighted sequences, and in the chronic cases, most of them were iso intense on the sagittal T1 weighted sequences. These are the pie diagrams depicting the same, that is, in the acute cases, most of them were hyper on T1 weighted images, whereas in case of chronic cases, most of them were iso. Distribution of sinuses: the most commonly involved sinus was superior sagittal sinus, followed by transverse sinus, followed by sigmoid sinus. Of the 50 acute cases, 48 were true positive and 2 cases were false positive on plain MRI with TOF MRV as compared to contrast MRV. Of the 10 chronic cases, 6 had complete recanalization and 4 cases were positive for CBT on contrast MRV. Of the 4 positive chronic cases, 2 were positive on plain MRV as well as 2 cases were false negative. So the conclusion: the most common age group was 20 to 29 years of age, accounting for 60% of the study population. And amongst the female patients, high incidence was seen in women with pregnancy and puerperal phase, accounting 57%, as compared to non-pregnant women, who accounted for 43% of the female population for the study. Superior sagittal sinus was the most common sinus to be involved, accounting for almost 62% of cases, followed by transverse sinus. Complete recanalization was seen in 60% of chronic CVT cases. The sensitivity and the positive predictive value of plain MRI, including non-contrast MR venography, in diagnosing CVT was 100% and 96% respectively. Specificity could not be calculated in the acute cases as there were no false negative cases on plain MRI. The sensitivity of the non-contrast MR venography for chronic cases was 50%. Specificity was 100% and the positive predictive value was 100%. Overall sensitivity and specificity of the plain MRI with MRV in diagnosing CVT as compared to contrast MRV in our study was 96% and 75%. By using limited sequence imaging, we were able to reduce the routine MR scan time of 20 to 25 minutes to just 10 minutes in suspected case of CVT. This in turn leads to avoiding contrast exposure, reduced cost of imaging, and also hastening the treatment of the patient. These are my references. Thank you.